number one, if that's true, then you need to figure out how to get your dog in the right place to get your livestock doing the right thing. So just like me over here trying to hold them along this fence line. Oh, man. He's not real keen about going into those tight corners and holding pressure. He either goes in too far or he doesn't go far enough. So like right here, there. He's gonna come too far and push him past me. He's fixing it because that's what we've been doodling on this whole time. Let's see how he didn't go far enough. There. We'll let him pass me because I want him over here. And if he needs to be there, that's fine. If they're comfortable here, that's fine. But I've got one that's not comfortable there. She's looking for an escape, so I've got to put him on that one. So some of this is going to be my dog is there. And when I said there, he took those couple of steps past the point where he should have, and that's what's going to kill you, and that's what's going to make your livestock not do what you want him to do in the moment, is because the dog is probably lacking in a skill. He will go along the fence and scoop him off. He's not looking to hit those corners with square planks. Genetics, a lot of these dogs don't have really square flanks, and some of it is training and experience. Good boy. Let's see, if I wanted to hold him here and I continue to just push him, let's see what happens. There, that was good on A, but then he pushes too hard, because what is he, a cattle dog? Put that one back, and then I show him where I want him by me holding him here. I don't want to let him split these off too much because I do think that sometimes they find joy in that, especially these dogs that like to move their feet. That was a good response right there. Perfect. He's holding him where, exactly where I want him. She was the one that wanted to split off. So if I want to kind of push her to split, see what he does. Not making an attempt to cover, right? Okay. Once he had them all turned to me, he took those next two steps just a little bit too far. And if I wanted him to scoop him off right here, like, I couldn't do that with him because he's pretty green. But an advanced dog, you should be able to give the AWAY command and get them right there along that fence, and me just kind of guide these sheep straight forward. I don't think that's going to happen. No command here. Get out of that. Let's see, if he'll go into that pocket and he'll hold pressure there, I can influence these sheep to come off the fence too. And he keeps coming out of the pocket so they're not moving. And if he won't stay in the pocket, that's what's going to happen. He wants to pop out to the tight, to the open side, not the tight side. He doesn't want to cover the tight side. Okay. Right there, he popped out again. See? So maybe my next step would be to send him all the way through. And that's the other thing. If they're going the wrong way and you give a correction, you want them to stop, right? Stop. Let me redirect you. You could start throwing out a ways and come bys, but a lot of times people's mouths don't match up with the same on both sides. Oh, wait. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Oh, wait. I know a lot of people really like to get stuff slow. What you need is a dog that's just really responsive to. But to slow it down like this really kind of can help you see the reason why these sheep are not coming off the fence here. They'll go. He doesn't, he pushed that one out and doesn't want to let him go. Get around. Want us over there because you keep putting us there. So then once they've kind of learned what the dog will let them get away with, because he's done this, there we go, again, done it again, then the sheep are less likely to participate in this exercise because they know how to dodge the dog. Our dogs to do stuff that doesn't make sense just because you may need that application one day. I don't necessarily need this today, but if he would go, come. He doesn't want to. Good. The sheep start learning what your dog is failing at. Same thing with the cattle. If you're trying to load cattle or you're trying to move cattle to a specific place and your dog fails once and fails twice, you're going to have a heck of a time getting those cattle where you need them to be. They learn. They learn very quickly. That is their defense mechanism. Being a prey animal is to learn how to outsmart the predator. Because all they have, especially sheep, all they have is being able to run and flock in a group. Cattle can kick and defend themselves to a point, but they also will run and kind of stay with the herd. So the more times your dog shows a weakness, and it's, you know, it's just a green dog. He's not, I'm not going to say he's weak. He just doesn't have a skill yet. He may be truly weak in that skill genetically, but I don't feel comfortable saying that yet. I've worked him 5 times. Good boy. You are doing good, buddy. Good boy. But all you can do is keep putting them in that situation. Try to change something up just a little bit each time. I always tell people, if you see something happen once, make a note, because if you see it happen twice, you're going to have to step in and change it if you don't like it. If it's something you do like, of course, continue to let it happen. But if it's something you don't like, once you've seen it twice, you know that is going to be something you have to work on.